This is the true story.
True story.
Of six improvisers.
Six improvisers.
Start their own show.
And find out just what happens.
What can happen.
You take something pitiful.
Truly pitiful.
And turn it into applause.
Applause.
This is.
This is.
This is.
This is.
This is.
This is.
Pity applause.
Hey, I'm Paul. Paul Gabriellini. My friends call me the Duke. Well, they don't, but it'll catch on. I'm from a little town called Long Island. Well, for some people it's a little bit bigger than a town, but for me it's town-sized. New York City, town-sized. Now Texas. Texas is a little bit bigger than a town, which is where I was born.
Good morrow, fellows. My name is Samantha Marie Therese Nugent. I am a dramatic actress. I am also an impassioned food service employee. I'm really excited for this learning experience. I'm a little worried that I'm the only one taking this seriously, but my parents always say it's hard for me because I'm always the smartest person in the room, so.
How's my headroom? It's okay?
Hold on.
Oh yeah, this is a mess, and it's out of focus. All right, clap. Great, get out of there. Hi, I'm Eric Striffler.
Hi, I'm Sam. You can call me Moyer, I guess, because there's other Sam, so it gets confusing.
So Sam, Jesse, and Sam? Wait, you're Sam and you're Sam? Well, somebody has to change your name.
Fine, I'll be Sam too.
So I'm just supposed to talk about myself now? I'm an actor. I do improv. I've got a dog named Pepper and an imaginary friend named Stuart. My favorite color is yellow. And blue, like them both. Am I done yet?
Hi there, my name is Lee Becker. I'm engaged, have been for about 3 years. Big difference between engagement and marriage, you know what I mean? I work at a wine shop, and some people think I drink too much. They use the term alcoholic, which I think is a little harsh. I prefer the term beverage enthusiast because, well, I find it to be more of a strength than a weakness.
Hi, I'm Jesse Roth. I'm Jewish. I'm looking for a guy who's like funny, but not funnier than me, you know? This isn't a dating show. What am I doing here?
The show? Oh, I love it. Gives me a chance to show the world the real me, you know? And who doesn't want to get to know me? You know those beer commercials about the world's most interesting person? Those are about me. Chuck Norris? He took notes from me. The Statue of David? That's this guy. It was cold that day. That's not who I am. Everything but the penis is who I am.
See the shadow on my face? That's you. You're casting a huge shadow on my face. Could you move, if you move that way, a little more. Great. See how it looks good now?
People really feel like they can open up to me and I can't blame them. I'm the best at keeping secrets, so. I can't tell you, then it wouldn't be a secret, silly. But I was astonished when Lee sold some of his sperm to pay for an engagement ring for his fiance. Scandal!
Yeah, this is where the magic happens. What's gonna happen? I don't know. That's the fun of it. In improv, you gotta feel out the stimuli and respond, you know? And a room full of people are watching, it's a lot like making love to a woman. How was that?
Paul, how long are you gonna keep up this tough guy act?
What act?
Is this whole crew following us on stage?
Of course, honey. How else are we gonna film it all?
You can follow me wherever you want.
Where are we gonna put everyone?
Yeah, the six of us hardly fit on stage as it is.
Please, don't worry your pretty little heads about this. Let us worry about it. It's what we do.
So you don't think all this is going to be a distraction?
Polly, you won't even realize we're here.
Let's give it up for the cast of Pity Applause!
Ladies and gentlemen, we are so excited that a TV producer wants to make a reality show about us. I can't even... Oh, but I promise we will not forget you when we're famous. For now, let's start this show off with the dating game, in which a volunteer from the audience will ask three prospective partners a few questions in order to decide who is their ideal match. This is Dating Game.
What's your favorite place to be?
My favorite place to be is in your arms. Or, well, I mean, if you want to get a little raunchy, I guess, inside of... Never mind.
Now, backstory number one.
Yes.
Same question.
How about alone and then with someone special?
Okay, so alone is definitely naked in my room. And then with someone is, naked in my room.
That's right, number two.
Hi, I'm Samantha Marie Therese.
Oh, I'm Jessie.
Favorite place to be other than, morgue? I would be at school.
Very nice. All right. So now there's three very different answers.
Yes.
Next question.
If someone were to give you $1 million, what would you do with it?
If I had $1 million. Is this like right now?
Like right now, I'd give you $1 million.
Huh? Oh. If I had $1 million, I would light it all on fire. And run around throwing on fire money at people saying, "You can't afford it!" I've always wanted to do that.
Jesse, if you had $1 million, how would you spend it?
Well, Chris? I'm a practical gal, so I'd probably pay off all my student loans. and that would make me a better like person to date, because then there'd just be nothing I would worry about.
I guess you're sort of considering Chris in that.
Yeah, because I don't think I'm ready to date anyone with all that student debt.
Samantha, you have the misfortune of being the last.
I would find your favorite things that cost $1 and buy $1 million of them.
Wow. That seems like an unnecessary effort. Final question. Make this a doozy.
A doozy? If you had a superpower, what would that superpower be?
Wow, Lee, if you had a superpower, I'm totally just repeating what I said. What would that be?
If I had a superpower...
We're good.
Man, if I had a superpower, it would be to make everything fuzzy. This is lovely.
Touching it.
But besides making everything fuzzy, which you'd probably get weird really quick, I guess it would be to make everything turn into alcohol, because then it's a party all the time. So fuzzy things and booze. Just like Jesus. Just make him appear.
Was Jesus a superhero?
All I know is that you were supposed to have one superpower. Jesse, if you had a superpower, what would it be?
It would be to read minds, because then I'd always know what you were thinking. And it's not creepy at all.
Samantha!
I would have the power of hindsight, so that I could see what you wanted and learn from my mistakes in the past.
Wow, what sheer honesty behind that answer. Chris, who would your ideal love be? Bachelor number one, Lee. Bachelorette number one, Jesse.
Yeah, yeah.
Or bachelor number two, Sam.
Oof, that's a tough one. What if I went with the fourth option, the host of the show?
You said we wouldn't know you were here.
And?
We know you're here!
Paul.
This is ridiculous. You guys need to lay off, okay? We can't do our jobs with all this junk in the way. So cut out the fat and all this techno mumbo jumbo. Sorry you had to see that, Sam.
What a drama queen.
I know, right?
Always in a terrible mood.
Tell me about it.
And the things he says about people.
I know!
I couldn't believe when he was talking about you.
Wait, what?
Well, he has something to say about everybody, am I right?
What did he say about me?
I thought you knew.
What did he say?
I couldn't possibly.
Tell me!
It wouldn't be right for me to say. But I could show you.
Sam is fat. Sam is jumbo. Sam, need to lay off with all this junk, okay? So cut out the fat. Sam, this is ridiculous. Fat mumbo jumbo. Fat. Sam.
Sorry I had to see that.
Why would he say those things about me?
That's the harsh reality of TV, honey.
I don't even know what to say.
You don't have to say anything, Sam. But I do know something you could do.
What's that?
Well, you know, you could maybe give him a little taste of his own medicine. Help him see how he made you feel so terrible.
Like revenge?
Your words, not mine. But, yeah.
What did you have in mind?
Well, I just gave that producer a piece of my mind.
So no more interruptions?
We should be golden.
Good. I can't take the stress.
Is that thing on?
Hell if I know.
It's like a giant eyeball that never blinks.
Okay, well, now it's turned on. You're welcome, by the way.
It's not the only thing that's turned on.
I have a girlfriend.
I'll make you forget.
I hope it's you that gets cut.
Gets cut?
What do you mean?
Rumor has it one of you guys is getting the boot.
What? Why?
I don't know, ratings? They can't do that. Actually, they can. You guys signed a contract.
I didn't sign anything.
Actually, I signed for all of you, but I used my left hand so the signatures would be different.
But they'd all look the same.
Hey, can you drop the drunken act?
What act?
Wait, if one of us gets cut, you guys stop following them, right?
Nobody is getting cut.
But I volunteer!
So what do we do?
I know who to do.
Okay. What do other reality TV shows do? We should just do that.
At first, I really liked Derek's idea. This is not what I had in mind.
Now that we've got this crew staying out of our way, let's get a little more physical with human prop. Throughout the scene, Moyer and Eric will become props whenever Jesse or Lee need them. As suggested by the audience, the first two props are a...
dildo.
And a...
Bigger dildo.
Bigger dildo!
Okay.
This is human prop.
This is the best anniversary present you could have ever given me.
Well, which one do you think's bigger?
Well, this one's clearly bigger, but size...
Is it because it's black? Is that why you think it's bigger?
No, I'm judging based off of sight. But just because it's bigger doesn't mean that it's more effective.
No. Well, check out what this one can do.
Whoa!
This thing's like a jackhammer!
Oh, yeah.
And it also sings.
Oh.
I believe that was from The Little Mermaid.
But I actually got you a present.
I can't wait to see it.
I got you, since, you know, we're keeping with this theme of sex,
yeah.
I got you, like a sex swing.
Well, look at it.
You know, it's like you,
Oh, we forgot, the other half's over here. You didn't even put the whole thing together.
It's a big swing, and you just kind of get in it.
Yeah? Is this for both of us, or just...
No, just you, honey.
This is just you. So how do I sex in it?
It seems like you already got the hang of it.
No, you're right. You're right.
Seems like you can't do it.
That feels about right.
I got a camera, so let me get out my camera. Thank you. And I just take pictures of it.
This is the best anniversary present ever.
Next is a little something called Death in a Scene. By the time this scene ends, one actor must die. You hear that, Paul? I'm gonna fucking kill you. As suggested by the audience, the location is a...
post office.
This is Death in a Scene. Next!
I would like to open up a P.O. box, please.
Well, they're over there. You can just open them yourself, can't you, mumbo jumbo?
Well, I believe I need a key.
Oh, here you go.
And I need to fill out a form, I believe. I may know your job better than you do.
No, you don't.
Sorry, I was. That was my attempt at humor. I'm a little nervous. You haven't blinked since I got here.
Well, you need a pen to fill out the form?
I do. I have a pen. Oh. But I'll use yours.
No, I
would love to use yours.
No, please.
Okay.
Now, do you need a form?
Well, yes. I don't want to write on your desk.
Oh, how are you going to get a form? Oh, I don't know.
There's a tray when I walked in.
No. Those, no. You can't use those. Those.
What? Why not?
Here's a form. Go ahead, sign it. Are you too fat, mumbo-jumbo?
I mean, you don't have to be in shape to fill out a form.
Do you need help? No, I'll come out of my little kiosk and I'll help.
I think you're okay where you are.
Oh, here I am. You need a help. What's your name?
Well, that's also illegal because...
That's
not my name.
Okay, and weight, 435 pounds, okay?
That's inaccurate.
And height, 2 feet.
That's how tall I feel
hair,
right now.
Plastic. What else, huh?
I don't know, I think I'm pretty wounded.
Yeah. Oh, how are you?
Yeah.
Here you go, here's your form. Oh. Now, next thing for a P.O. box, you have to get on your knees. Do you want a P.O. box?
Why is the door shut?
Oh, the post office is closed.
Oh, then I better go.
No, stay! You can do it
do my job better than me. How about you go behind the chaos there?
All right, this is fun if it wasn't scary.
I'm just gonna close the door.
All right, what can I do for you today?
And close the window.
Did that to Paul. But hell, I'm sure he deserved it. I mean, I can't tell you how many times that I've wanted to just...
Hey, Lee, dear, can we talk for a minute?
Yeah, what's up?
Well, there's no easy way to say this, so I'm just gonna come out and say it. We're taking your character in a different direction.
My character was a...
I know this is sudden, a shock, really, but we think it's best for the show if you're not in it. So look, we have a couple of changes that need to be made, okay? First of all, we replace Lee.
We did?
Second of all, we need to add some spice to this chili. So, Paul, we need you to be gay.
But I'm the tough guy.
Well, now you're the gay.
The tough gay?
What?
I can do that.
The tough gay?
I can be the tough gay!
All right, whatever. Just be fabulous.
And tough!
The rest of you, keep developing your stories. The audience is loving you. Great work, everyone. Oh, and Nugent, I'm so sorry to have to do this, but I have something else to show you.
What?
Well, it seems like Paul wasn't the only one who had something to say.
I wish Sam had been replaced and not Lee.
Sam looks like her father peed into her mother.
Why would they say those things about me?
I don't know, honey. People can be...
Bitches!
Your words, not mine. But you know what you have to do now, right?
Revenge.
Hello, I am the real Lee, and our next scene is Actor's Nightmare, in which Paul and Jesse will alter their emotions based on Moyer's offstage instructions. As suggested by the audience, the location is a...
Yeah.
This is Actor's Nightmare.
Whee!
Ooh.
Yeah, keep dreaming. You know how it makes me feel? When you just catcall me from across the gym or next to me in the gym? It makes me feel intruded upon, okay?
You're so sensitive.
Yeah, I'm gay.
Give me more gay.
And I'll beat your ass in more ways than one if you were a man.
I'm horny.
And I'm horny. Not for you, though. But when you work out and you tie your hair back like that, you kind of look like my ex Byron from high school.
Jesse, you're disgusted.
Ugh! What kind of name is Byron?
He's from the Philippines, although it's not a Filipino name.
Ugh! Philippines. Like, where is that?
Some of the best gays come from the Philippines. Like myself.
Paul, you're depressed.
Alright, now I wear a tough exterior. Because I have to. Being a gay man, you have to be tough.
Stereotypes are disgusting.
Yeah, you bet.
Jesse, you're overjoyed.
Oh, my water.
Are you pregnant? Is that...
No, you're gay!
Oh, why'd you say something about water?
I was drinking water and I spilled it, but it doesn't matter.
God, I just don't get it.
Oh.
I mean, I get who I am, okay? I'm gay.
That's beautiful.
And I'm tough.
That's beautiful.
You don't have to tell me that. I don't need a Princess Diana story.
Paul, you're overly confident.
Because I'm me. I'm a big, tough gay man from the Philippines.
Yeah, you
and
are.
And I used to date a man named Byron.
Okay.
Who's also from the Philippines.
I love the Philippines.
And I dated other men who weren't from the Philippines.
Okay.
Not that I'm, you know, like, think about things like that. But,
Jesse, you're terrified.
But the Philippines, they're pretty cool over there.
The Philippines?
Yeah.
What? Is that in South America?
I don't know, actually.
I don't even want to know.
I think it's like a cross breed of Asian and Hispanic.
Oh, God!
You go to Scared Straight Camp for 6 months and tell me how you turn out.
What? There's a camp?
Yes.
A camp?
No, there's a camp to scare gay people straight.
What?
It's not to scare straight, it's to scare gay people straight.
But wasn't that a thing like in the 70s and now it's gone?
Yeah, I look good for my age!
Oh my God!
In Senseless, one actor will be blind and the other will be deaf.
What would you prefer ever to be, blind or deaf?
Deaf.
Deaf.
As suggested by the audience, the location is a...
Subway.
The sandwich shop or the underground?
Underground.
We've actually had that
we
distinction
had
before.
This is Senseless.
Okay, working my way down the stairs, and...
How long until my train gets where I'm going?
Okay, bench, that'd be great.
Oh, here we go, creeps on the subway. Yeah, that's me.
Okay, I'm
yeah,
sorry.
Don't you
I'm
hate
sorry.
When this happens? Someone comes
yeah.
up to you on the subway and just grabs your face. I think I'll move.
That's probably a good idea. You just go. Actually, where would be a good place to sit down? I'm not entirely.
Do you have any trouble over there?
Yeah, yeah, I'm having a lot of trouble. I'll be fine.
Here.
I just.
Here's a dime.
Okay, I'll take a dime.
Here's a dime.
I don't know where you are. Okay, great. This will pay for my baby, I guess. I don't know.
Say, what's your name?
Judy.
Jimmy? Good to meet you. My name is also Jimmy.
Oh, okay,
Low five. Thank you.
Oh my gosh, I got it!
So where are you headed?
Home.
Me
Washington.
Too, actually. I can't believe we're not there yet.
Yeah, yeah.
Can you tell me how long this train takes? How long have you been on the train?
Well, I just got into the
wow.
station.
Wow, so you just got on.
Yeah, I guess right. I'm on the train now. I didn't realize. I guess I walked right on the train from the steps. Wow. So,
yeah, sure.
That
a seat just opened up if you wanted to...
Yeah, where, okay.
Oh!
Where
you okay?
Is the seat? I don't know where to find it.
Yeah, you can take that seat. You take it. Go ahead.
Okay, I'm
it's all yours.
Afraid.
I'll stay over here.
I'm a little afraid to sit down here.
It's weird to be on a train at 2 a.m., huh? We're the only ones here.
I think I found the floor.
Yeah?
Yep. This is not
need
where
a hand?
You want to be. Yep. Yes, I do. Yep.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Aha!
Yeah, you're okay.
And that was my spleen.
My dad didn't pee into my mom. I can't take it anymore!
Sam, pull it together!
Everyone is looking at me!
Sam?
They're always watching.
Oh, calm down.
You're not real!
Can you please just cool it? All right, the show's almost over, then you can have your little freak out.
This is all your fault!
Should we stop them?
Nah, it makes me kinda hot. Sam's all right, I guess, but enough about her. Let's look at me. Okay, we're good.
My name is Lee. Sam's face makes me want to kick puppies. I would rather let Hillary Clinton sit on my face than have to look at Sam another second. She smells like cheese. Was that good?
They all will pay!
We are going to finally end this show with directed scene, in which actors perform a scene multiple times in different genres. As suggested by the audience, those genres are...
horror.
Fan fiction.
And...
adult movies.
Soap opera.
And I'm gonna make them look like fucking idiots.
You can get away from me!
This is directed scene.
All right, actors. The scene takes place in a taxidermy shop. You are the taxidermist. You are the animal.
Okay. What kind of animal am I?
That's up to you.
Okay.
Change it every time. You know, you're an actor,
okay.
So improvise. You know. So you know, just you know, taxidermy, right? You're gonna figure it out, all right?
So I'm just a dead animal.
Yeah.
I don't speak.
I mean, you can. That's up to you. You're an actor. Okay? But you have to, you know, get on all fours.
Okay.
Like an animal. Action!
Well, this sucks.
You're telling me. This is my first day as a taxidermist.
Yeah, and you're already talking to animals. You're fucking crazy.
Guess I'll stuff ya.
Do it.
All right. Got my animal
cut, 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 cut. You're not even stopping her. So let's take it from the beginning, okay? Because you didn't get my direction the first time, all right? Okay. So we're at a taxidermy shop. You get that?
Yes.
This time, it's horror.
Okay.
Horrifying.
Okay.
Okay? And I want you to start stuffing her sooner, okay? And you know how you stuff an animal, don't you?
Yeah.
Gotta go in from the front and the back.
Of course.
But think horror.
Horror.
Okay? So I want to see fear. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Action. Ah!
Black shit.
Oh, the haunted taxidermy. It's time to stuff the animal. From the front and behind like you stuff animals. Comes alive, my child!
Yeah, I know. You know it was bad. I know it was bad. We were all watching, right? Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. Oh my god, I have it. Okay? So, okay, listen to this. She is you're still a taxidermist. She's a horse.
Okay.
You are obsessed with horses. Okay?
Okay.
Like equus. You know equus?
I do know equus.
You know where this is going then, right? Action!
All right.
Okay.
Horses are so beautiful.
I am a horse.
I know what you are. I'm here to stuff you myself.
I love it. I'm such a fan.
Stuff you back here.
Yes. I'm a fan of that as well.
Curve of the buttocks.
Oh, yeah.
Strength. The legs.
I'm a fan of this.
Okay, cut. Oh, okay. Yes, please cut. Thank you.
That was good, but not good enough. All right, it wasn't exactly there.
Okay, so, since you guys
can't really take direction very well at all,
I'm going to over-direct you, all right? So, you've seen soap operas, right?
Yeah.
Do either of you speak Spanish?
Un poco.
Okay, bueno. All right, so, here's what you're gonna do, okay?
Right.
So, you're...
Something wrong with your back? Because you're hunched.
Shh! Okay, so you're going to come in and you're going to be like, oh my god, I have to stuff this animal, right? And you're going to be crying. And you have to, you know, drink her tears. and then you're going to... You are going to turn around and come alive and end it. Your hand up, please. Action!
Oh, adios mio!
Hola. Me llamo Lee.
Okay. Yo soy un horse.
Lo siento, por favor.
Oh, adios mio! Oh, yes, so nice. You know, I have to, can I do something for you?
See. Hola!
Yes!
Lee! Lee! You just punched Lee!
No, I'm fine.
Woo! This is so exciting! Gonna be